The low-hanging fruit of green building are the low-cost, low-tech building techniques which reduce energy consumption and increase energy efficiency. Mankind has utilized many of these since our beginning on this earth.
We started to mass-produce houses, stick build them, and started to standardize the building processes. Then it became, they became less indigenous. If you go back, you know, 100 years, they were probably practicing better green building practices than we have been in the last 50 years. They're using local material. They were trying to capitalize on as much of passive means of energy as they possibly could.
When we first started looking for a home, one of the things I knew was the fact that the American home had already doubled in size since around 1960.
Get your home energy efficient before you move on to some of the other more romantic or sexy green things.
There are many tried and true, not very exciting things that have a very high return on your investment.
Siting the house properly to capture solar benefits.
Make sure that the building envelope is as airtight as you can get it. The second thing would be the amount of thermal insulation you put in the walls, ceiling, and floors.
Actually, one of the first green features was insulation.
One of the single most beneficial things you can do is to tighten up the envelope of a home, reducing draft, basically. Add more insulation or better windows or pay attention to air sealing because draft is a huge source of heat loss in a building. Caulk and weather stripping, very simple things for people to do, don't necessarily need a contractor, but that's one of the highest by far payback items. Clients install like LED lighting. There are a couple of companies that make very high quality LED lights. These are products that use about 85% less energy than a conventional incandescent bulb. The same light quality. Another area that people need to take a look at more aggressively is natural lighting. One of the products that we've been using with a high degree of success in the last few years are what are called sun pipes.
Another skylight that really permits me on a sunny day to work here in the office without having any artificial lighting.
Another tried and true technology that should be considered in most climates is the installation of ceiling fans, because the ceiling fan can reduce the need for air conditioning.
Shower heads, sinks, toilets, you know, all of them have the, you know, water saving features.
Preventing it is just education. We've been doing, builders, remodelers have been doing things by tradition, so to speak, rather than basing it on science. To encourage the low-hanging fruit would be probably marketplace-driven. How can builders incorporate this? Because it is a step in the direction of being able to build better. And it's the most cost-effective steps. That's why it's the low-hanging fruit. So if you can get them to recognize that they can deliver a better product at low or no additional cost, that's a huge incentive. Some of the other ones would be to aggressively pursue zoning changes that could increase density to create more open space.
I think you start out with some of these less exciting technologies and techniques, and then you lead into geothermal or solar, because basically, if I can build a building that uses 50% less energy than a conventional structure, which we commonly do, if we take that building and then there's room within the budget, with or without incentive money, and we can afford to put in, say, a geothermal system, for example, well, that geothermal system is half the size of what it needed to be. So I've somewhat exponentially increased my impact on my energy bill and my environmental friendliness.